Train journeys can be so exciting when you're traveling in a group. But what do you do when you're traveling alone or with just one another person and you're really bored? So here are 9 ways you can be productive on a long train journey. Firstly, you can eat much more peacefully, taking a lot more time on a train as against in the final few minutes of you leaving your house before your journey begins. But do remember to not keep snacking continuously and remember to keep account of the number of chais you drink, because you might just end up eating much more calories in the form of snacks as against proper healthy meals. You can actually clean your phone. All of us have a few unnecessary photos and videos which block up way too much space. On a train, you do not have internet and you also need to save battery. But the best part about this is you can keep your phone on flight mode and still clean your phone. It takes a lot of time, but you have all the time in the world. You can also go through your apps and some of your other videos. Number 3. Finish your work which does not require internet. In my case, I created a few thumbnails. I also edited some videos. You can also draft some emails and keep them ready and send them when you have internet when you reach the next day. This is so much more productive as against watching downloaded programs. Now, another thing you can do is you can actually get ready in advance. This will save up so much time. You can literally just drop off your luggage and you'll be ready to leave. You can put on some basic makeup, some nail paint, comb your hair, spread some perfume, and you're done. Now this is me in my childhood. I would always study on the train. Usually when it's an overnight train, there is only so much socializing you can do, and if you have some homework left behind, you can definitely sit up in your personal berth and get on with it. Number 6. You can pamper your skin as much as you want because you have all the time in the world. I decided to go about my normal skincare routine but with much more time and patience. You can definitely do some packs, some sheet masks, and you can actually do it with your family. It'll be so much fun. Number 7 is networking. On the train, you meet so many new people, so you should definitely promote your business. Number 8 is playing cards and other board games. Before boarding this train, my mother gave me one task, and that was to pack cards, which I forgot. So we had to buy these from the station. You do get 2 packs for just 60 rupees. And we played cards for not less than 3 hours. If you're alone, you can definitely play solitaire because it's so much fun. And if you have a pen and a notebook or just a paper, there are so many other games. Like you can play the classic X and Zero or Connect the Dots. And I beat mom right there. There are only such few amount of times where you're with that person in one metal tin box. So use that time. Just talk to them. As a bonus tip, do stay hydrated. I know that the train washrooms are not the most hygienic ones, but for that you can actually carry some sanitizers and some hygiene wipes, which are actually featured in one of my favorites. I'll leave the link down below if you want, because if you don't stay hydrated, that'll be much more harmful than not using the washrooms at all. So these were my tips on how you can enjoy your train journey. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye and have a very safe journey.